Michelle, we were supposed to speak about madness today, but you told me that you would prefer milieu.
Milieu seems to be the more relevant concept these days. It refers to the issue of security and hence also to epidemics, quarantine, etc. But let's wait and see. Madness may also play a role here.
Okay, where do you want to start?
Well, perhaps we start with the security apparatus. In the late 1970s, in my lectures at the Collège de France, this was the actual context in which I talked a lot about the milieu.
Why was that?
Well, the concept simply belonged together with the concept of population. It is something like its counterpart. If you want to talk about biopolitics, you also need to speak about populations and their milieus.
But population seems to be a rather abstract, if not statistical, notion.
Precisely. If you want to do statistics, you need to define your object, or rather field. You have to circumscribe the territory you want to look at. For example, a region or a city.
In your lectures, you talk a lot about town planning and the design of urban spaces.
Back then, that was a hot topic. Henri Lefebvre would talk about it. Fernand Braudel did quite some research on the history of cities. Even with Deleuze and Guattari, I had some very interesting discussions about urbanism. But that's a different story.
So back to populations and milieus.
Discipline structures space. Remember Bentham and the Panopticon? Discipline addresses the essential problem of a hierarchical and functional distribution of elements. Security operates in rather different ways. It tries to plan a milieu in terms of events or series of events or possible elements of series that will have to be regulated within a multivalent and transformable framework. In other words, the security apparatus does not focus on designing single architectures. Instead, it aims at reflecting and modifying urban space.
Is a milieu then something like an environment?
In a certain sense, yes. A milieu is something in which circulations are carried out. Circulations of people, but also of things and words. It is a hybrid form. The milieu is a set of natural givens, rivers, marshes, hills, and a set of artificial givens, an agglomeration of individuals, of houses, etc.
I guess I need more clarification. In The Order of Things, you describe Cuvier as the inventor of the environment in the biological sense of the term. Following this account, Cuvier appears as the first biologist establishing a crucial link between the living being and its conditions of existence, the air it breathes, the water it drinks, the food it absorbs. However, in the history of madness, the milieu appears as everything artificial that was created by man, religion, literature, art, up to the point where you say, the milieu began where nature began to die in man.
I admit it is contradictory, and this is precisely the reason why I wanted to talk about the concept of milieu. Eventually, it stands for an axiomatic topic, the relation between the organism and its environment, or Umwelt. This was crucial already in Canguilhem, but it was already of key importance in Kurt Goldstein, Henri Vallon, and many others. At the same time, this relation is not simply an exterior one. As early as in the 19th century, physiologist Claude Bernard established that every organism has an interior milieu.
And the puppets? They also seem to have an interior milieu. At least here it is the human hand that, from the inside, provides them with life.
Well, more interesting and probably more important is their exterior milieu. It usually corresponds to the world of children, theater, entertainment, and so on. When puppets appear in intellectual milieus, this is often seen as inappropriate.
Yes, when you combine thinking and puppets, you quickly come close to madness.
Without madness, however, there would be no thinking. Bye-bye.
Bye.